Hey, welcome back everybody to another episode of Agrarian Skies 2. Last time, at the end of the episode, if you guys remember, we set up this export over here for all the crushed ore. And right after I was done recording, I noticed that I had a servo and a piece of item duck in my inventory. And that was because I removed the cover in the front here, and that pops out this item duct and this filter. That's what it was, not a servo. And so I had to set that up again, so you know our production here is not messed up. And it made me, well, I had to move to, in order to get all this back in here, I had to move that export bus to the front here of this chest, which is okay. It doesn't really bother me that much. It's not the prettiest, but hey, this is a workshop, right? And the other thing I changed is I didn't like the anchors also because I automated this here. I'll show you in a second. And then I would have had to add more anchors so it doesn't connect to the front one. You guys remember we had these three on one and then the other eight here on another channel up here from these cables, because these can only hold eight channels. And it kind of bugged me, and I'm like, you know what, we got so much bone meal and cactus greens. So these are the two main colors I'm going to use, white and green. From now on, I'm gonna try to stay away from flux cables as much as I can, besides maybe, you know, up here right next to it. But yeah, I think that's good. But anyway, that's it working the same way. And I added this right here. There's an import bus that whenever we do something in here, it gets sucked out. And up here, I just have one recipe for now to make flux crystals. That is the only thing I've did here. And over here, I prepared something we'll get to in a second. What was the other thing I did? Nothing. Oh, yeah, that's what was. Here we go. I added a few recipes just for pistons and then a few of the ME parts that I'm going to need often. And also the gears. I think I mentioned that last time that I want to figure out how to automate all the gears. And you guys see I prepared the patterns already. You know, four iron ingots for an iron gear. These right here we can directly craft. We don't need to set it through the smeltery, the bronze, the tin, and the copper. But these other ones here, and I've been using them, yeah, quite often. Not really the iron, but the other ones here I've been using quite often for, you know, the thermal expansion, upgrading stuff, and so on. Well, and it turned into a pain in the butt. So, but let's start with this corner over here first before we do the gears over here. And there's one more thing I kind of want to automate today. And that is the charge crystal automation. If I need more of those, I just want it to be ready. And for that, I had to clean out this corner, which got rid of the sorting barrels here, which is no problem. Because from now on, we're simply gonna suck in the finished processes directly from this last inscriber that puts them all together. You know, all these different parts with the silicon and the redstone to make the actual processor. So all I do is put an import bus right there. And let's hook this up to this. So now that gets pulled in. So I don't care about the sorting chest and barrel and stuff up here anymore. And the other thing we gotta do is, I am gonna make one of these and put this on top of this barrel. Yes. I still want to keep the barrels, so when I order 100, it just sends 100 here at once. It should. No, that depends on the pattern. So it's still going to send one after another, but that is fine. We can keep this here for now. Now, the only thing is, can I? Sweet, I can still hook this up. And in this one, we're going to put this pattern right here. One Sirtis Quartz crystal turns into a charged Sirtis Quartz crystal, and it's still going to pump it in here. And then all we got to do is set up another import bus to the side here. So this way it goes directly back into our ME system. Let's test this real quick, just to make sure it works. Let's order 5 real quick. And okay, so it did put them all at once in here, and it's gonna charge it. Which, now thinking of it, we can actually save some, because we won't need this down here anymore, because it's getting this power through the ME cable now. You can power this with the ME cable. So that saves us a little conduit here, which is fine. Awesome. And let me just close up this area now, so it's all nicely tucked away. All nicely put away, actually. Nah, that doesn't bother me. Nah, it does bother me. Let's do finish this up nicely with two more over on this side. I gotta remove these two real quick. It didn't let me get through the block. And bam, bam. All right, cool. So it's all nicely tucked away and all still works. And it's automated, which is the coolest part. And now let's go ahead. Let me just show you guys real quick. First, I ran this green cable above ground because you guys remember I said I want to keep all the ME stuff above coming down so we don't get stuff mixed up on the bottom and don't run out of room and so on. But it looked really ugly running this cable over the ceiling here. So I did go down and then went along in the basement. Just show you real quickly. And it's not too bad down here. I can still walk underneath it, so that's important. But the weird thing is, ever since I put this cable here, let me show you, every one of these connects. You say, see this? Every time you place an MQB cable, a fluid duct wants to connect to it, which makes no sense to me. But since then, I have this graphics bug here where the lava sometimes shows and sometimes doesn't. It happened after I placed this cable, so I'm not sure what's going on with that. But anyway, I come out of the basement right there, and it's nicely put away. I don't want to, you know, have an ugly island. All right, you know what? I should sleep real quick just so we can actually get some light going. Come on. So, what the deal is with the smeltery, I'm not sure, my FPS is also a little slacking right now, but I'm coming up right here, and I think I want to do something else. I just noticed over here and over there in that hole. It would be nice if we fixed that. I made a recipe for that just now. Missing a quartz. What? All right, I'm just going to make them by hand. I figure out this wrong pattern here in a minute. But I want to make covers for that. That kind of bugs me. And might as well do it now. No, not like that. I gotta remove this one. Bam. Now I can cover it. There we go. Now it looks nicer. And I want to do the same over here. Just so it's a little prettier. Bam. Okay. So the cable comes up here. And I've removed the hopper and the chest. We won't need that anymore. And you know, now that I'm thinking of it, I do kind of, don't we have, I can make one of those in a second. Sorry, I'm getting sidetracked here. I should stay on track. So let's first up set up the interface going into the chest here. That's what's actually going to hold the patterns. And we're going to have these five right there. Okay, and then all I got to do is put an import bus right on the side of this, and that should pour it out. And you know what? Let's make a test while we're at it for one of these, just to make sure it works. Which one? Let's make another Invar gear. Here we go. And that should send it here. And it's already starting smelting. And then we'll see in a second if it gets pulled out automatically. And while we wait for that, I need to make a redstone card for that import bus, meaning if I need to do something in the smeltery, you know, if we want to make another, what am I doing? If we want to make another weapon or an upgrade or something like that, you know, it's automatically going to pull it out into the ME system. And I kind of want to make it so we can toggle this on or off. Okay, I gotta make some of these and then one like that. Cool. And I still have this, and I'm gonna need a lever. Just it's not really needed. I mean, I could always just have it in the ME system and then pull it out by hand again, but I think it's nice to have this option over here. And the way we can do that is simply put a redstone card here, always active without signal. It doesn't have a signal right now, but we can put a Well, we're gonna put it here, or let's put it right there. And now, if I turn this off, it is not going to pull it out. It already did the invar gear and pulled it out. So now, for now, I'm gonna leave this on, because whenever I order gear, I want it to come back into the ME system automatically. But if I ever make something by hand, I can turn it off. I think that's pretty neat. So what is next today? Now we got these parts done, and it's quite happy. I don't want to continue with the auto crafting up here. I want to kind of figure out what are the things I want to auto craft first, and I still have plenty of spots. But the most important things now, when it comes to ME, you know, import buses, export buses, interfaces, and cables, those to me are the most important things about ME. They're all automated in here. I can request them all. And right here, this is all the things that are automated. I think that's pretty nifty. Also, you know, like pistons is nice to have. And this is good. This is good for now. I'm not going to worry about it more for the time being. Simply going to make patterns on the go when I know I need something more often. And of course, eventually we're going to set up here, you know, all this stuff, like, you know, so I can automatically make Signalium, Inderium, Invar, Electrum, all these things, which are right now I just put by hand and over there. So it's not a big deal. But the other thing I want to do today is I want to kill a wither. We're going to kill that. But in order to do that, I want to get into making myself new armor. And that's what we're going to do now. So in order for us to make any of the bound armor, like the bound boots right here, the chest piece, the legs, and the helmet, we need to make a soul armor forge, which is four of these filled sockets and some stone. And this is like the crafting table we're going to use. And then the armor itself we're going to make out of these filled sockets. So we're going to need 24 of these right there, plus four right here. So we're going to need 28 of them. And they're made by tossing this empty socket in on blood altar with 30,000 LP. We got this covered here, no problem. But in order to make the empty sockets, we need a lot more weak blood shards, okay? And, well, we need more of those. I think right now we have 10, so that's nothing. So we're gonna need to farm mobs by hand, and I figured, not sure how I'm gonna do this yet. I'll figure that out in a second. We might just use the tower for now. But anyways, and in order to get the blood shards, you need to use a bound blade, which you need a binding ritual for, and toss a diamond sword into. Okay, so that's no problem, but we need to set up a new ritual, and I kind of want to have this in its own area over there. So I started expanding the island again over here with a little bit, where I figured we kind of set up two rituals or three over here, and then maybe put our demon slaying area later over there, something like that. But sorry, some motorcycle's driving by and it needs attention. This torch right here, it's gonna start having problems over here. And you guys remember that I set this one all the way over here on purpose so the tower doesn't get affected. And I want to leave it there. But I know of a second torch we can get from the quest, making the sigil of the blood lamp. So I want to make the sigil now so I have a magnum torch. So when I build an area like this over there, I can just set it down and make sure nothing spawns until the area is done, because it has happened to me before. So anyways, that was a lot of talking, but I kind of wanted to give you guys the rundown of all the things we need to do right now. And we'll make the sigil of the blood lamp right now. Finally, I wanted to have this for a while, and I only had one torch. That's cool. All right, let's put this into our sigil of holding, and I'll show you guys what that is. Whoops, mouse wheel. Is this the right thing? What is this one? Oh, the water sigil. Oh yeah. So sigil of the blood lamp, you click somewhere and it places this little light, which is kind of cool. And I wanted to do a test here first. All right, I'm not sure what's going on with these slime bricks down here. They just don't seem to work. But I figured we can actually use this to our, not advantage, but actually I need to put this one higher. I don't want this stuff to be exposed. So we are going to just use a regular clay right here and there, and then make some kind of a steps right now. It doesn't matter, I can pretty this up in a minute. So they're gonna land here, actually. Yeah, that's what I need to do. I need to bring this. Let's go like that and put a slab. So now I'm at ankle height. And I can use these slabs to close this off. And then use this here real quick. It doesn't matter. Just so they cannot jump out. And I put the four lights in here. And I figured if normal rules apply, why does this not flow further? Is it because of these lamps? Are these lamps in the way or something? Yes, okay. Well, yeah, of course. I put the lamps on one higher earlier if it would have been with that. Sorry for the derping, guys, but we'll get this figured out here. A, I want to use this as a test. If zombies are gonna... What? I cannot place it there? Oh, I gotta change it to the right thing. Duh. Here we go. Is this the blood lamp? Yes. So now it is at face height for them. And if I put this back here, because if I have the witch water back there, that also means that the mobs are gonna get flushed towards me. So I should be able to just hit them right there. And hopefully that works. But we just gotta test this. So I'm gonna turn off the grinder right there and turn this on up there. I just wanna see if it works right now before we continue. Because this means that we can use this also to get our blood shards when we have that ritual set up. But right now I just wanna see if they do survive. Because I remember we put in these bricks there because they didn't survive, but they did. Yeah, okay, so they do survive. They're not taking any damage, none. All right, so that's pretty good. It also makes them hard to hit with all the bouncing. All right, so but it works. We can get our blood shards this way. So let me turn this off, because I don't want a million mobs down there in a minute. And turn on the grinder again. And now we can turn in this quest and get this magnum torch. So now you do your thing. And I'm probably gonna just make this a little wider right there. Bam, bam, so I have something to walk on. And you know what? We don't need this. Let's do it like that. I have more. So we can actually just step on here like this. So that's good. Problems with the XP again. But these are all gonna get killed now, so that's good. And I'll turn in this quest now. Let me get rid of this stuff. Alright, good. And we get that magnum torch. That's what I wanted for right now, so I can continue building this platform over there. And it shouldn't, yeah, it should not affect anything. And bam, there it goes. Now I'm sure that nothing will spawn here. Nothing has spawned yet, even though this is the top half of the block. So this is perfectly spawnable area. But it doesn't show you until you make it a full block. I don't know. That's something wrong with NEI. And I'll go ahead and continue building and get everything ready so we can set up the ritual binding, get the blade going, and yeah, hopefully soon get this armor. Guess who's got tired of making obsidian by hand? This guy. Put an aqueous accumulator down there. New igneous extruder. Getting the lava from over here. And now I just can take out one stack at a time. And that is a lot better for the lazy. All right, and I also added four more wireless cards up here. We're up to 80 RF now. I think we had, no, we had 10. I put 16 now, so six more. And it's 80 RF a tick. So now I can really go to the ends of the islands right now. Because before I was getting a little short. So. We're gonna need 24 here. I set the diviner already to the ritual of binding, and it says on the bottom we need 24. And well, that's what I needed the obsidian for. So let's get this orb in here, and let's just make, we're gonna need four for the master, and there's four more. So I'm just gonna make as many as we need right now, and let's get ahead and make the master ritual stone. And there we go. So now we have, what? I must have had some in here. My bad. All right, but we got everything we need, I think. Oh yeah, and of course we need the diamond sword. Bada bing, bada bing. This time I have sticks, sweet. And there we go. So if I'm not mistaken, I have everything we need now. And I didn't do too much back here on the platform because I don't know yet what I want to do on the right side, but you guys see I didn't put any more pumpkins or jack-o'-lanterns around it because I'd like to use these things right here, the sigil of the blood lamp more, especially in this area. You know what I mean? I mean, this is blood magic, so let's use it. So, sweet. Oh no, it is right. It does need a 9x9. So let's just go ahead and set this up. And it should stop. There we go. And this is what it looks like. So now what I want to do here is, don't know if I want to use, all clay again. I definitely, I don't want to do this. I want to have water in the middle here. And I'll explain that in a second why. Let's just go like this. And then I think it looks kind of silly having the wood down here. Let's just get rid of this for one second. This should be quick. And of course, I'm gonna need this guy down here also. And I'm just gonna go ahead and fill this with all this bloodstone sorry about that. words are hard sometimes. We're not using any cactus here. I don't even need to cut. Bam, there we go. And then out here, I think I'm gonna just use the. Actually, you know what? Let's go like that. I think that is good. Just like this. I know you won't be able to see it, but it still might look better this way. And three more. And now we're just gonna fill in the rest with the green clay. Oops, there's another one we need here. Did we get this one? Yes. Okay, so now I can fill this in with the green clay just so it doesn't look like it's unfinished. And a few more over here. So the ritual of binding, when you use it, you guys see there's gonna be lightning, okay? And if this item here that we're making afterwards drops and falls down into the fire, you lose it. So you kind of want to make sure that you have water in here. The fences actually might burn up and stuff. We'll see in a second. It's nothing that we cannot fix. So let me go ahead and actually, we're going to activate it first. So we just right-click this once. It costs a ton of LP. Let's see if I can find out real quick how much it was. A million. It filled so fast it didn't even register. Okay, and whoops. Now I want the blood. Why can't I place this? This is a water sigil. Why can't I use you? Hello? What's happening? This doesn't flow. All right, this is very it just needed a second apparently. Put another one here and there. Yeah, I can live with this. I think this is okay. I still don't understand why this is weird here in the middle. It must be because of this ring or something. But anyway, let's put it back in here. And now that it's activated, every time you use this, you need to activate it first. And now we can take this diamond sword, and I actually need to take off the ring for a second. So we are actually, let me see if I can chuck this on there. Get ready. Bam. There's the lightning. This is the ritual itself. Sorry for headphone users. Might be a little loud here for a second. And that's it. Cool. Defenses are still there. And where's my sword? There it is. I guess I can put the ring back on. Bam! We got our brown blade. Sweet. You guys see how it looks like a sword in here, but when you actually do F5, you got this big ball here in my hand. And that is because it's not activated. When you shift right click, now it is activated. Because as soon as you activate it, and oops, wrong one. And it is active, it actually uses LP the entire time. Also, when you kill and stuff. But we're generating LP so fast that you won't be able to see it. It won't even register. Now, where did this blood lamb shoot to? Probably off the island or something, or somewhere. I probably shot it far away. Anyway, so this is done. Now, if we want to make something else, like the bound pick, bound shovel, and so on, we will need to, you know, activate it again. But for now, we got this thing, and now I can get to farming. And that's what we really needed this for. And we can turn this on, and we can also enchant that sword and stuff eventually, you know, with sharpness. And I think that looting also works, so you get possibly more shards. And I just saw the four blood lamps are still in there. I still want, oops, I gotta turn this off. I am, the whole reason, you know, why we put this in there was so we can find out if zombies can destroy those lights, or if they do, I should say. Let me get some. Oh, I have slabs on me. I don't need this anymore. This, and I just need six more. Well, this was really smart. Why is there cave spiders? Why is there cave spiders? Holy shnikes. Oh, they must be turning into those. Let's go ahead and kill some stuff and see if we get any blood shards with this. Yep, got two already. But anyways, I wanted to... Alright, these cave spiders suck. I don't like that. I wanted to put that here so we can just step up on the sides also if we need to. And we're probably going to get a lot more heads and stuff now when we're killing by hand. I don't know. Eventually, we always going to have one manual kill room. Especially later when we get into Thorncraft. Oh man, this XP is annoying. Am I not hitting them? Is there something to hit for me? You know what? I can put these away. And go closer, so it should be easier to hit. I don't need this anymore. Oh, oops, that was the wrong one. Bam, bam, bam. Yeah, I think this is gonna make it easier to hit. And possibly the XP will get to me easier too. Man, I bet we're getting so much gobbledygook right now. Alright guys, let me go ahead and farm here until, you know, I get close to a stack or something of these blood shards, and then we'll go make these frames that we need, the empty sockets. I don't know if it's possible to actually empty this here without, like, sharpness or something. They just keep coming faster than I can kill them. And, well, I've been at it maybe 10 minutes or so now. And we got almost a stack and a half of this. So let's just go ahead and turn this on to get rid of them. Don't care. And empty all this gobbledygook. So, actually, you know what? We can turn this off up here. We don't need it anymore. At least, and look how many mobs. I definitely would like to rebuild this one up here with, like, a flushing system. I have a pretty good idea. But that needs to wait, or maybe we, you know, when we get to Cursed Earth, that's it. Then we don't need to worry about this at all anymore. So, now that we have a ton of these shards, let's go ahead. Oh, another thing is you want to make sure that you, you know, you don't need to, but I like to disable it when, deactivate it when I don't need it. And let's get rid of this bone. So, socket. Let's go ahead and make, so what did I say, 24, I need 28 of these. And we should have enough of this. I don't want to do a right click to make sure I don't get more than I need. There's a few other things. 24, really? I don't have enough blood shards? You gotta be kidding me. Well, that's all right. We can get the process started of filling these up, I guess, and I'll keep killing. Now I gotta turn it on again. Math and me. I'm usually pretty good at math. I thought I'm gonna have enough. Alright, so let's get more mobs going. And we don't need you right now, so yep, put you over there. And yep, we just do all of them. Bam. Puts them all in here. And yeah, the altar can easily keep up. It's no problem at all. Ooh, so I thought. Uh-oh. That doesn't look good. So do I need to do these one by one? You gotta be kidding me. It only needs 3,000. Wait. Wait. 3 or 30,000. Okay. Can I set this up to only go one at a time? Let's see here. 64. What happens when I do one at a time? Can I? Oh, there we go. Just one. The nearest first, ignore, use NBT, use metadata. I want to see what happens when you only do one. If it's gonna know, hey, there's one in here. Well, let's just do two. It should send one. It does send two still. Okay. Well, it looks like I'm gonna have to do this the hard way, one at a time. Well, that kind of sucks. Excuse me, will you fill, please? How much should we got? 4,800. That's pretty crazy. I thought that we're gonna have enough. I might have to add a few. Are they still all here? Where did I go in again? Was it right here? Yes. You guys are all still here, right? Not that something happens. 2, 4, 6. Did I only make six? Yes, I did. So I'm probably gonna add a few more witches. To make sure that we can keep going more with this. I don't need you right now. But let me tell you this. We're gonna fill them. I should be able to fill one here quite soon. Let's just keep it going. Let's see what happens. Turn this guy on again. And creepers exploding. And I'm just gonna, keep getting blood shards. Oh, yes, a creeper must have blown up and killed everything. I must have. Oh, and by the way, I switched this to regular water instead of the witch water because I got tired of the cave spiders. There was constantly cave spiders because the witch water turns the regular spiders into cave spiders, and they just kept swimming out here, and it was quite a pain in the butt. I mean, it wasn't dangerous, but if you maybe I gotta go AFK, phone call or something, and then next thing I know is I'm dead or something, and that would suck. All right, so it filled this one, no problem. So I tell you what, guys, to save us some time, I'm gonna go ahead and get more shards, make all 28 of these, and fill them all. And I'm also now going to, ooh, I can show you now. Check it out. You see how this is constantly going down? That is A, due to the Well of Suffering, because the witch is down there, that ritual needs LP to run, and also because this bound blade is on. You can't really tell what is what, so let me put this guy in here just to keep it full until I'm ready to make all the sockets. All right, finally got these 28 filled sockets, and the way I did it is I took out all the speed runes and these two runes of capacity and replaced them all with runes of sacrifice. And altogether, we have 15 witches now. I made 9 more, not 6 like us. Actually, we had 6. Yeah, no, 15. Yeah, that's right. We got 15 of those now. And I was easily able to keep up when I put 24 at once in here without any problems. So now we got tons of LP. And yeah, let's go ahead and make this armor finally. A whole episode just preparing to make a set of armor is pretty crazy, isn't it? But let's go here. I can never remember. Oh yeah, Soul Armor Forge, that thing right there. We need to make this one. Oh, can I? Do I need to get the big orb? No, I don't. Cool. So there's our Soul Armor Forge. And there is a lot of things we can do with the armor when we build it. We can put sigils in it, but that is not something I want to do today because, well, I want to kill the Wither. And I really want to do this before anything else. And the best way now is we're just going to make this armor, make a golden apple, make a. Get some milk if I don't have any, and bow and arrow, and we go and kill it once and for all. So let's see here. If I want to make the chest, I need to go up here. And booties, helmet, it should all work. Let's see. Bam. And what do I need to click on? Nothing, I think. So let's go ahead and let's make the chest piece first. So all you do is just like in the crafting grid. Whoops, that was one too high. All you do is, the same pattern. You gotta be kidding me. And then all we do is right-click this thing here. Bam. Oh, we get our chest piece. And we do the same with the legs. Come on. And helmet. Now the cool thing is about this armor, that when you take damage, it actually takes LP out of your network. I think every heart of damage is 300 LP, so this never takes any durability damage, and it also does 90% absorption, I believe. There's a flask we need to make in order to get 100% absorption. If you guys haven't used, there we go. If you guys haven't used blood magic in a while, that changed a few updates ago, quite a while ago actually. Do I need to right click them first, bind them to me? I don't know, let's just do it that way. Yes, I do. And only if you have the full set on, then you get the full bond armor effect. And look how cool we look. We look like a samurai with these claws and stuff. I love it. I think it's, my opinion, the coolest looking armor in the game. I absolutely love it. So now what else do we need? We need soul sand, 4 of it. And I'm just gonna leave this armor in here. We don't need it anymore. We won't have any flight right now, so that is the only thing that could be a little dangerous, but that is fine. Golden apple, I might have one over there, but let's just make one. Bada bing, bada bang. Let's make 2 of them. And I don't have any potions, right? I do a fire resist. I'll take one of those with me. There's a lot of other sigils and stuff we're gonna make to put in that armor. For example, then we're immune to lava. We cannot drown and so on. But that's in a upcoming episode that we're gonna do that. So 2 of these. Do I have any milk? Can I drink this milk? I never tried that. No, I can't. All right, no problem. I think that with MFR, right, we need to make these in bottles like that. Yes. Okay. Do I have any bottles? Yep. Let me just take 3 with me. I'll go run over. I can't fly anymore. I'll run over to the cows. I think there is a, maybe there's a cow. I don't know. Hopefully. Yes, I see cows. Cool. And you guys also see, while I was waiting for all this, I replaced all the glowstone nooks down there with these new blood lights and so on, because I really like them so much better. And look at the tower, even that is lit up nicely now, and you don't see the light sources. I really like these lights. You don't see them until you're actually quite close, which is the biggest thing for me. Oh wait, I forgot that we, how did I get the milk last time? I know I got, wait, what? Did I not get milk? Hmm. Can I do it with a bucket? I think I tried this a while ago. Okay, so with a bucket I can do it. So I'll just take this one bucket of milk. That should be enough, because I won't use it until after the fight. And let me go ahead and get the 3 skulls from over there, the bow and arrows, and then I'll meet you in another where we summon the wither. Not sure what's going on. I came down here from the portal, right there, and I just wanted to make a kill room for the wither, right? And I started digging here out. I wanted to make a little small room, and I just found Soren. And it's a custom NPC. I don't know what that is about. What? So I guess I have no idea what this is for. I mean, do they just randomly spawn, or is this guy supposed to be here? I think custom NPCs don't spawn randomly. I'm pretty sure they don't, but I'm not sure what's up with this here. Chest, we get a raspberry iced tea, Aperius, Lippy, Arborist, and Skystone block chest. I don't know, so I just wanted to show you guys, if you have any idea what this is for. I don't know. Let's check the quest book if something completed. Yeah, these 3 are just mob hunter down here. I haven't turned them in. That's just from all the killing I did. And we just get, you know, weird rewards that we don't need now. So yeah, I don't know what's up with that, but I guess I'm gonna have to make my kill room somewhere else. Alright, I got this prepared here, and what I'm gonna do first is take this fire resist potion, so I don't need to worry about that. I made 3 regen 2 potions just to have something in case. I've got the milk here, and that is all I need. I got these ender pearls with me, just in case I fall down or something, because we don't have any flight. And that way I can, you know, possibly get out of harm's way. And let's see what this wither got for us. Come on, do it. Blow up, my friend. I'm using the sword, by the way, because the hatchet actually does two less damage than the wither. Should have probably made a little lower the sound. Sorry about that. Oh, that was quite easy. Oh, that's funny. Let's make some light here. That's one thing I love about this. You can just go around and light everything up and done. Let's see what we got. I can't believe it. We got the nether star, but we still did not get a sigil. Where do we get a sigil? I thought that sigils are pretty much guaranteed from... what? From wither kills. Unstable ingot. Division sigil. Alright, I got this prepared here, and what I'm gonna do first is take this fire resist potion, so I don't need to worry about that. I made 3 regen 2 potions just to have something in case. I've got the milk here, and that is all I need. I got these ender pearls with me, just in case I fall down or something, because we don't have any flight, and that way I can, you know, possibly get out of harm's way. And let's see what this wither got for us. Come on, do it. Blow up, my friend. I'm using the sword, by the way, because the hatchet actually does two less damage than the wither. Should have probably made a little lower the sound. Sorry about that. Oh, that was quite easy. Oh, that's funny. Let's make some light here. That's one thing I love about this. You can just go around and light everything up and done. Let's see what we got. I can't believe it. We got the nether star, but we still did not get a sigil. Where do we get a sigil? I thought that sigils are pretty much guaranteed from... what? From wither kills. Unstable ingot. Division sigil. What? Wish to get it in the next page. Okay, I don't want any of that. I want to know, and cannot be crafted, but is found in dungeon chests. However, in its rare state, it is useless. Well, that's awesome. That sucks, guys. I really wanted to get flight today with the angel ring, and we took very little damage. Have you guys noticed that? I'm gonna have to look for some Enderman real quick. I gotta hit some. I wanna know if this is actually what. Is there something up there? Yes. Alright, come here, buddy. I wanna see if. Something hit me. Hit me. I'm not taking any damage. Is this not. Oh, there it is. Half a heart. Okay, you hit me too. Come on. Alright, so okay, I do take some damage. I wasn't sure if this is maybe the version where you don't need a soul hardened flask, but we do. Alright, cool. So, well, guys, I am not sure. I'm gonna have to do some research now and find out where we're gonna get the a sigil from. I mean, there's gotta be a spot where we can get it. Maybe it's a quest. Please don't extinguish my portal. Let's just go home. We got the Nether Star, but we could have made that one. I'm not kidding, guys. Every other version I played before. Really? That would have been bad if that would have knocked me off. Oh my god, I would have been so mad. Oh, that would have been bad. Anyways, like, sorry, another motorcycle going by. Yeah, I'm gonna do some research and try to find out if you guys have any clues or hints or suggestions of where we can get one of these sigils. I mean, we have killed lots of mobs, right? I mean, lots. Can we see this? Where is this again? Nah, they say in dungeon chests, but well, maybe it's in a reward bag. Anyways, guys, we got the ritual done. We got our armor done, which is super cool. I'm happy about that. That's really good armor. And was no, I wasn't full when I killed the wither. There was no items. I had the magnet on, so it would have sucked it up. There's no way. Anyways, it was good episode, I think. We got lots done. And even killed the wither boss. Which, by the way, let me empty my inventory real quick. I know it's getting really long. Sorry about that. Finally remembered what I was gonna do. I was gonna check the quest book. If we, well, A, we can claim the spiders here. This emerald, it's all stuff we've had before. I thought there would have been maybe a quest to kill a wither, but apparently not. We can start working on some quests next time also. Well, too bad, guys. I don't know where we're gonna get us. Oh, there's two with unclaimed rewards. Is that here? Here? Where are we at, guys? Here. Another quest complete. Find the surprise. I think that was probably Soren. Pick one. Well, the bag. It's a no-brainer. And the end is a lie. What? When did I complete this? Not sure. Let's open this bag. Hopefully. What a slap in the face. Yeah, we got an awesome couch. Thank you very much, Jaded. That's awesome. I really appreciate it. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed the episode, and hopefully we'll get flight next time. Anyways, take care, stay safe, and bye-bye.